Hello everybody. Dissent at 70. I can define it in just one sentence if you want, but since I have 10 minutes, I'll speak. Dissent at 70 in India means my dissent is better than your dissent. That's what the whole fight is all about. Initially, I thought that I will also, I did some research, I thought I'll speak like, I'll give you an academic point of view on dissent. But I'm a filmmaker, not a media person. My job is not to give opinions. My job is to observe and tell you stories. I'm a storyteller. So I'm going to tell you the story of my life, where and how I faced dissent and what happened. But before that, I just want to tell you a small story because it will put everything in a context. There was a man who went to a church and he asked a priest, "This wine, is this Jesus Christ's blood?" And the priest said, "Yes." So he said, "You mean to say intellectually or actually?" And the priest said, "Actually." He comes out and he meets a crazy girl, an insane girl, a mad woman. She's carrying a Barbie doll and she's telling everybody, "This is my baby, this is my baby." So he said, "You mean intellectually or actually?" And that mad girl said, "Actually." Why I'm saying this, just replace that doll with idea of India. Now the whole debate is, there's an old school of journalism, old school of politics, old school of filmmaking, old school of narrative. They're still carrying a certain kind of narrative. They believe this is the idea of India, this is how the India should be. And in the process, what has happened is that India has died, the idea of India they had. There is no India in that idea of India. India has changed and they don't know the pulse. Somebody else knows the pulse. He has taken over the narrative, which can be the new government. You can call him Modi, it can be social media. And the ideas which were supposed to come from the media and from the people who create narrative actually are coming from the prime minister of the country, and that's why everybody is rattled and they are saying there's no space for dissent. I spent most of my time in advertising, then in filmmaking, so I was mostly in a capitalist world. But I'll tell you how the whole thing began. When I was studying in Bhopal, in a university, in Bhopal University, there was the principal of our college. We saw him very often opening the doors of education minister's car, you know, making him sit first and always standing, giving him a glass of water. We thought that this guy is succumbing to the establishment, and we took out a rally and we protested against him. And that day, since I led that protest, that day everybody called me, the principal called me, and he said, "I am suspending you for a few days because you are a Naxal." That day I become a Naxal. Cut to, I'll talk in a film jargon, cut to, a few years ago in 2014, early 14, or I think 2013, late 13, when Narendra Modi's nomination was confirmed that he is going to contest this election. Lot of creative people, mostly from the film industry, led by the first name, a letter came which said that a fascist government is going to come, a fascist leader is contesting elections, and it is the responsibility of the creative world and the intellectuals of this country to stop him from becoming the prime minister. All of you know about that letter. When it reached me through the association, I said, this narrative has been there for a long time. These people are the beneficiaries of a certain nexus. So therefore, this is the establishment. That narrative was the establishment. And I was the first person who refused to sign that letter. A channel which Barkha runs, NDTV, they invited me on a 9 o'clock show. Sorry, I'm taking names because then only you'll understand what I'm trying to say. I'm not here to criticize anybody. There was Nandita Das, there was Anand Patwardhan, there was Elit Padamsi, and one or two more people who are well-known people for 10, 20 years they have been talking against Modi, against RSS and all these people, and I had nothing to do with politics. I was the only person who had refused to sign that. Everybody else had signed that letter. And that was, I was very new to this panel discussion on TV. When everybody started attacking me, somewhere as a reflex, I told Barkha, why are you guys behaving like an intellectual mafia? And that was the last day I ever came on NDTV. Next half an hour, nobody gave me the mic. Few years later, recently last year, when the Kanaiya episode happened, I'm not bragging, but I'm just telling you, in our house, we don't have cable TV and we don't subscribe to newspaper. That's why you're very happy people. That's why I believe that India is a happy country. I saw same Barkha Dutt screaming that the space of dissent is shrinking. I said, wow, brilliant. That's why I'm trying to say my dissent is better than your dissent. At that time, I was dissenting, though it appeared as if I was with the government, but actually I was taking a stand which was against the establishment, and since that day, my job opportunities within the film industry have shrunk. All of you know about it. And for the first time, somebody on social media that day called me Internet Hindu. So from Maxwell, that day I became an Internet Hindu. Then there was intolerance debate and award wapsi, all these things happened. Anupam Kher called me, he said, I am taking out a march, would you want to come? I said, no, I don't want to get involved in politics. But next day I saw on TV a so-called poet and author, writer, Mr. Ashok Bajpayee was leading a campaign called Award Vapsi. Suddenly I remember 1974-75, Guptaji was talking about emergency, I'll tell you what is like emergency. This was just few months before emergency. Dushyant Kumar, all of you know about him, and Sharad Joshi, I'm sure you know, who wrote Andhon Ka Hathi. Both of them were suspended by Ashok Bajpayee because they refused to participate in a function where Indira Gandhi was coming, because they refused to take orders from Ashok Bajpayee, and they called him openly that they were dissenting against him. They were suspended. Dushyant Kumar died of heart attack on 75. Sharad Joshi died as a pauper with no money, just a one room in Bombay. That is emergency, when creative people are killed like that. I've seen that time. I was very young, but I have that impressions in my mind. So when he was leading that award vapsi saying intolerance, I again said, wow. And then I called Anupam, I said, I'm going to participate. And that day everybody started calling me Sanghi. So I became a Sanghi. Then I made a film called Buddha in a Traffic Jam. All of you know about it, so I won't get into details of it. You know how it was. JNU decided not to show it. The Dean of Cinema Studies refused to show the movie. And this was when Kanhaiya episode was taking place, and all the top journalists of this country, sir, I'm just telling you about the emergency-like situation. All the top journalists of the country were screaming. They were screaming that the space for dissent is shrinking. That time a very important movie came in this country, not because it was mine, the first movie ever which said that there is a possibility that there's a nexus between the intelligentsia, media, NGOs and Naxals, and it's a truth that there is a nexus. Not even one journalist stood up and supported the film. Forget the film, nobody said, I stand with your dissent. I respect your dissent and I will report exactly what's happening with you. Rupaji knows, my shoulder was broken, my car was broken in Jadavpur University. I tweeted help. You know who came for help? The common students of India. Not one journalist. And since that day, wherever I go, I asked these small young girls and boys, the so-called the vernacular journalists of India, you know what they tell me, and this is a very sad commentary, and it really pains me a lot. Wherever I go, they say, sir, we work so hard. Day and night we are working, we hardly earn any money. Why are we called media traders? Why are we called prostitutes? It's not our fault. I'll tell you why it is happening. If you want to understand how the role of media, now I have seen in last 1 year, media people, the journalists, especially the eminent and senior journalists, always in conferences, they are justifying themselves. What is happening with them? How Twitter is treating them? I'll tell you what is happening. If you remember in the movies of 50s and 60s and up to 70s, you look at the role of a journalist, a poor guy fighting for the cause of oppressed, fighting for the society, wants to build a great India based on truth, equality and all those things, then suddenly that role changed since the advent of Shah Rukh Khan. I'm saying Shah Rukh Khan because Amitabh Bachchan and Shah Rukh Khan. The same journalist became an urban guy, started wearing trousers and jeans and shirts, sometimes started singing songs also with girls. And he wasn't concerned about national cause, the cause for a common citizen. He became localite. He started fighting for a person rather than the society. And the journalist in today's movies is shown as a corrupt, rich, filthy rich, corrupt man who is become an oppressor. So for me, that is the establishment. And anybody who stands up against him is a dissenter. So media today has lost the credibility and the right to call themselves dissenters. They have become the establishment. Why is it? I'll tell you a very subtle thing you have to understand. Our most watched movie in this country is PK. Most loved, because most people have seen, no movie can be most watched if people don't relate with it and relate with the characters. Look at the irony of that movie, look at the irony of our society and the state of media in this country today. In that movie, the journalist, all she wants is a great story and TRPs. An alien has to come and tell her and change her heart and convince her why it is important to look for the interest of a common man. That is the in-depth analysis of that movie. Last thing, I just want to say, this identity crisis, this credibility issue is coming because media has become very aware of itself. When a filmmaker or an artist starts thinking that what I'm going to write, what I'm going to create, what impact it's going to have within my fraternity, what people are going to say about it, that day he loses the objectivity of the whole issue. That's what media is doing. But jaise kehte hain, Bhagwan jab ek darwaja band karta hai, to dusra kholta hai. Times have changed. You have to live. Mohandas Pai was giving me some brilliant statistics today of artificial intelligence and all. I think in modern times, in these times, media is the establishment, is part of a nexus, and the social media is the new dissenter. The common citizen is the new dissenter, and which is why media is spending 90% of its time criticizing Twitter and defending their own position. So now the responsibility is on you guys. Thank you.